Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Education Institution, Kavetipati, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Good morning, students. In this video session, I would like to explain about adaptations of living things. In the chapter Population and Organism chapter, each and every living things must be influenced by the living organ, non-living abiotic factors. Okay, so when the organism is settled or survival in the one particular geographical places or one particular place, that organism want to show or living thing want to show something adaptation for survivability. So regarding that, plants adaptations in the different places, growing plants, that we have to discuss in this video. Dear students, here this video adaptation. Adaptation meaning it is when the living organism want to survival in the one environmental condition, that organism want to show something adaptive nature for that environmental conditions. Okay, for example, if you when we are joined in this school, it is a new environment to you. So up to now you are very well convenient place at your house. When you join in this school, you want to struggle to adjust some days. So when the organism want to survivable or maintain the life in the one new place, that organism want to show adaptations. So that's why here attributes of the organisms to the environmental conditions, it will show adaptations. That adaptations may be morphological adaptations or physiological adaptations and behavioral adaptations. So especially in this video, I would like to say about ecological adaptations in the plant, because of here plants are different type of plants basing on their ecosystem, based on their ecosystem. So what places are they are growing, based on the location of the plant growth, growing the plants, majority of the plants are divided, the classified into the several groups: hydrophytes and mesophytes and xerophytes. Hydrophytes mean hydro indicates water. So which of the plants can survive their life in the water bodies, those plants we call as a hydrophytes. Mesophytes, some of the plants are easily grown at the place of the terrestrial, which terrestrial places are having the very few water supply, that places growing plants we call as a mesophytes, xerophytes. In the terrestrial plants, some of the terrestrial areas not had have water supply much more abundant, so such a places we call as a xero. So in such a desert places, nothing but a desert places, like the type of a very less water availability places, grown plants we call as a xerophytes. Apart of these, some of the other plants also is there, halophytes and epiphytes. Yesterday we discussed about the regarding the soil nature. Soil nature, oxalophytes. Oxalophytes means acidic soil, and holophytes means sands, saline soil. So based on the soil, of course, several conditions are there, several types of plants are there. So here basically we are discussing regarding to the hydrophytes, mesophytes and xerophytes. Now first starting with the hydrophytes. when the plants are growing in the water bodies, such a plants we call as a hydrophytes. So when you observe the hydrophytes or water growing plants comparing with the terrestrial places growing plants, the body nature is different. Morphological characteristics also different because of a different environmental conditions from the terrestrial to water media. So here hydrophytes plants again classified into the submerged plants and free floating plants, amphibious plants and fixed floating plants and hygroscopic plants. Hygroscopic submerged plants are which of the plants are seen in the water bodies, that I mean in the bottom places at nearby bank, any river bank, pond bank, adjacent places, coastal places, these submerged plants we can able to see. Okay, amphibious, that mean some of the part of the plant body is above the water body, some of the plant body is seen into the water, inside of the water body, that is such a type of plants we call the amphibious. And then free floating, some of the plants grown on the freely on water surface area, but someone or plants are stick on that soil inside of the pond, but leaves will come out from the water surface. They are leaves are floated on the water surface, but it is fixing in the soil. And hygro means moisture absorbing, moisture places growing plants we call as a hygroscopic. Okay, whatever it is, submerged, amphibious, free floating, fixed floating and hygroscopic, based on their water in the water bodies which place they are growing based on. Here first these plants what type of morphological adaptations they are exhibiting. Morphological characters mean a physical appearance of the plant. Here we are discussing about the regarding the plants. Morphology means a physical appearance of the either plant or animal. Okay, so morphological adaptations, here what are the morphological adaptations we seen in the hydroscopic hydrophytes plants. Here first point, see pointer places, root reduced, roots are very reducing size is not much bigger size, and root without a root hair not at there, because of roots are essential for absorption of water from the soil. But here plants growing in the water places, water bodies, so roots are much not well important to well big long size. So here root size is a very reduced in size. Along with that one, root hair is not at present. Without a root hair, if root hair present on the roots mean it will more efficient to absorption of water. So here water plants hydro plants roots are reduced in size, root hair also not at present. Now come to the above part of aerial part of the plant, stem and petiole is a very somewhat of a long, and then leaves are in the ribbon shape. Leaves are very free movement, ribbon shape. Why leaves are in ribbon shape means if the leaf in the form of the width, leaf having the width occupying place mean that leaf getting the something pressure with the water flow. So when the water flow time, it will create the problem to plant, maybe sometimes plucking from the soil, it will detaching from the soil, it will causes a something life threatening problem to the plant. So if the leaves in the form of the ribbon, in the which direction water is moving, in such a direction that leaves will be moved. So easy flexibility of the leaves, so that's why leaves are modified in the shape of the ribbon shape. Okay, these and all morphological, by what I said here, that and all by seeing of their root or stem or leaf, seeing itself we can able to find, correct na? So this is the morphological adaptations in the hydrophytes. Then anatomical adaptations of hydrophytes. In the anatomical adaptations time, here stem without a mechanical tissue. Here in the lower standards, in the 11th standard, in the 9th standard and in the 11th standard, you studied different type of tissues in the plant. One of the tissue, mechanical tissue, that mechanical tissue is gives to the strength to the plant. If plant having the mechanical tissue, it have the stiffness. But here, which plants are grown in the hydrophytes, I mean water body, that water body plants, water plants, no need not of these mechanical tissue, because of the body want to flexible to move. So that's why these stem without a mechanical tissue, and along with that vascular bundles. Vascular bundles nothing but it tells about the xylem and phloem. That is xylem and phloem in the position of the center position of the stem. That want to remember. And a large space of the stem is occupying the cortex. Cortex, okay, large space of a cortex present in the stem places. And then air cavities. In the plants of the hydrophytes, air cavities, that some in between of the cells, something gap is there. That gap in extracellular space, nothing but extracellular space, that extracellular space having the long space cavities, that cavity is filled with the air. That air filling cavities are useful for are providing to the buoyancy. Buoyancy means want to float on the water surface. For that one, these buoyancy nature is given by the air cavities are present in their internal arrangement of a stem. Okay, that is one of the adaptation. And then stomata is absent, or if present, that is non-functional. Up to now, what I said, what I explained, that and all regarding to hydrophytes, different hydrophytes, plants, morphological characteristics, morphological adaptations, and anatomical adaptations. Anatomical adaptations, anatomy means the internal arrangement of the tissue in the inside of the microscopical or structure. Okay, microscopical understanding things we call as anatomical. Okay, these and all under anatomical adaptations and morphological adaptations I mentioned here. And then the same, similarly, some of the characteristics are we seen in the free floating plants and fixed floating plants. Here examples only I will say. Free floating plants, example water hyacinth and pistia, these two are free floating on water surface. On water surface it can able to grow without any contact with the bottom from the soil. Simply they are floating. But fixed floating plants, now the I am saying about the last one, fixed floating plants. These fixed floating plants are examples, nymphia, in Tamil tamarai, and as like marsilia, as like nymphia, marsilia is another example. Example you should be remember. Okay, and adaptations must be, there is a chances of some of the NEET based questions. Okay, up to now we completed what are the different type of hydrophytes, what are their morphological adaptations and anatomical adaptations we completed. Then come with another type of plant, mesophytes. Mesophytes, the which of the plants are grown at the place of mesic conditions. Mesic condition, general understanding wise, our garden plants are example for mesophytes. Nothing but which plants can survive their life on the normal terrestrial, that terrestrial place having the abundant source of water availability. Such a plants we called as a mesic condition or mesophyte. Okay, example our garden plants are example for mesophytes. These mesophytes are shows morphological adaptation. By seeing itself we can able to find the variation from the these mesophytes with the these xerophytes. So that is a morphological variation, morphological adaptation. Stem is rigid, one of the important character, stem is rigid nature, and large leaves. Here comparingly you have to remember, here hydrophytes leaves are in ribbon shape, But here leaves are large in size. Dorso ventrally suppressed. It is a flattened and root system is well developed. Why here root system is well developed? Mean roots want to grow to deeper level of the soil to up to reach the in the soil in which place water availability is there. Up to water sources, roots will be grown to absorption purpose. So root system is well developed, and then roots having a bearing root cap and a root hair is present on the root surface. When the root hair is present, automatically it will influence the more abundant absorption. Okay, influence the absorption. Rate of absorption rate will increase. So more water will be absorbed by the hair, root hair, because of by the root hair the surface area will increase, increasing of the root. So by the more surface area roots will absorb the more water. That is a more essential characteristics of the these mesophytes. Then up to now morphological adaptations we seen to mesophytes. Mesophytes are exhibit the what type of morphological adaptations. Now anatomical adaptations. In this anatomical adaptations, palisade layer. If you seen in the 10th standard, you are all are drawn one of the structure, leaf structure. Leaf structure. In the leaf, upper epidermis, lower epidermis, you drawn. The upper epidermis, two pore, upper epidermis kila, that layer down, one two layer structure, your alar drawn that, recall that one. Palisade layer, below the upper epidermis, sometimes lower epidermis also, these palisade layer containing with the chlorophyll. Now we are all are very well known about the chlorophyll characteristic, what is their function. It is a more significant role in the photosynthesis. So mesophytes are playing important role in the photosynthetic activity. So that's why palisade layer containing with a very fused number of chloroplast, chlorophyll in that one. And then along with that palisade layer, here mechanical tissue is well developed. Comparing with these hydrophytes, mesophytes are having the mechanical tissue is well developed. And then vascular tissue also well developed, because of these plants belongs to terrestrial places. So when the plant is adapted to the terrestrial places, they need something strong stiffy body. For a strong stiffy body, it will get from the presence of the mechanical tissue. And sometimes mesophytes are having a very long height, some of the more height. From that more height, water conducting or food nutrient particles supplying wise, xylem and phloem are want to develop very well. So that's why xylem and phloem is nothing but vascular tissue only now. So vascular tissue is well developed. So that is one of the important anatomical adaptation. And then when you coming to here, anatomical one of the adaptation of the mesophytes, no wax coating on the leaf surface area. No wax coating. Here I forgot to say here hydrophytes, that too especially fixed floating hydrophytes. Fixed floating plants are there na. Example tamari, nimbia, nymphia. That plant leaves you observe time on the leaf surface area, it's containing with the wax. It is act as a waterproof, correct na? Like such a type of water wax or waterproofing layer not at presence in the mesophyte. Why here not at necessary? Here if the wax coating is present, what will happen? It will not allowing the photosynthesis process. It is a create the obstacle to the photosynthesis. So wax layer is not at necessary on the mesophylls. So no wax coating. And then cuticle purely developed. Cuticle is a purely developed. Cuticle is present above the pot surface. I mean any anatomical pot or epidermis top layer we call as a cuticle. That cuticle is not at well developed, because of these mesophyte plant leaves stems are involving in the photosynthesis. So that's why chloroplast or pallucide layer want to expose to the sunlight. So that will influence the photosynthesis. So here, by the effect of that one, cuticle is poorly developed. These and all mesophytes, morphological and anatomical adaptations. What are the morphological adaptations? Stem is rigid, large leaves are there, root system is well developed, root containing with the root cap and root hair, and then anatomical adaptations, palisade layer containing with the chlorophyll, and mechanical tissue, vascular tissue also well developed, and the leaves or body surface area not at having any wax coating, and a cuticle is purely developed. This is about mesophytes. Now come with xerophytes. What are the xerophytes? Zero means less water availability places. Xerophytes, which plants are grown in the dried condition, such a place grown plants we call the xerophytes. Okay, that xerophytes also shown some of the adaptations. I think all the students are very well known about these adaptations. Example, desert plants. You have to recall in your mind desert plants. Desert plants are example for these xerophytes. See here, morphological adaptations of xerophytes. These morphological adaptations of xerophytes are these. Root system is a deep root system is there because the plant roots are grown up to some of the deeper levels, some of the deeper level of the soil, because of in which place, which zone of the soil having the water availability, up to that root system want to grow. So deep root system is present, and then stem is green color, that too it is a plain important role in photosynthetic active, because of in the xerophytic plants leaves are not at present. If it is present, it is a very small in size. Leaves are modified into the spine. Example, opuntia, recall that one plant opuntia. On the opuntia body, the total stem having a lot of spines. That spines only indicates the leaves. So come with these third part. Leaves are reduced in size, or sometimes that leaves are converted into the spines. Why leaves are modified into the spines? Why the leaves are converted into the spines? Because of these and all want to prevent the water loss. Xerophyte plants, they are going in desert, growing in the desert places. In desert places, a lot of more temperature is there. By the temperature, lot of transpiration chances are there. By the stomata, water will be lost in the evaporation. So that's why controlling of that one, leaves are modified into the spine. Lack of leaves, generally photosynthesis done in the leaves. But here leaves are modified into the spines, so stem will be playing important role in the photosynthetic activity. So that is a morphological adaptations in the xerophytes. Then physiological adaptations, this one very important. Up to now we discussed morphological and anatomical adaptations. Here one of the important characteristics of the xerophytes, they are showing the physiological adaptations also. What are that physiological? Physiological mean chemical changes or chemical metabolic reactions. That is physiological adaptations. So here in the daytime, close the stomatas. Stomata closing and opening is controlling by the potassium ions. Some of the stomata cells onwards exchanging of the potassium ions, chloride ions, it will promote the opening and closing of the stomatas. So in the daytime, closing of stomata. Why the daytime these hydrophytic plants are close their stomata? Daytime they are having the environment having the more temperature. If in that situation stomatas are open, mean lot of water maybe will loss. For prevention, that one they are stop the opening of stomatas in the daytime. Night time it will open. and then along with that CAM cycle of the photosynthesis. Okay, a special metabolic activity is done in the xerophyte. That cycle we call as a CAM cycle. It is in the photosynthesis. These are the physiological adaptations. Now, anatomical adaptations. Anatomic internal arrangement of the tissue, how they are arranged. Here, thin cuticle is present in the top of the body. Top of the epidermis. Thick cuticle is there, and deep sunken stomatas. Sunken stomatas means stomatas are present in the deep depression. Okay, stomatas are not yet exposing to the outer. Basically, when you have seen the stomatas in the normal mesophytic plants, okay, and the comparing the upper epidermis, lower epidermis having the more number of stomatas. Okay, that general in the epidermis itself it will present. But here in the xerophytic plants, these sunken stomatas are not yet present in the epidermis layer. Somewhat below the epidermis layer, they are present in the somewhat of deep depression places. Okay, deep groove they are present because of prevention of the water loss. And then palisade layer is well developed. Palisade layer means below the epidermis of the leaves layer we call as a palisade layer. That palisade layer we well developed, that containing the chloroplast, chlorophyll, and then that is maybe multi-layered in the leaves. Leaves it is present in multi-layer, many more layers. Okay, in this place, xerophytic places grown plants are having the hypodermis and sclerenchyma and conducting elements means nothing but vascular tissue is well developed. Hypodermis mean epidermis below layer we call the hypodermis. Sclerenchyma, a special type of a tissue, and conducting vascular elements are well developed. These and all regarding xerophytic adaptations of xerophytes, morphological adaptations, physiological adaptations, anatomical adaptations. One see deep root system is there, and then stem is green color and photosynthetic nature. Leaves are reduced in their size. Sometimes it is modified into the spines, prevent for the water loss. Physiological adaptations, in the daytime they are close their stomatas. In the photosynthesis, a special cycle, CAM cycle, is exhibited by the xerophytic. These two are physiological adaptations. Then come with the next one, anatomical adaptations. In the thick cuticle is present on the epidermis, and the stomatas are in the mode of sunken stomatas, and palisade layer is well developed. Maybe sometimes palisade layer in the multi-layered. And in the anatomy of the tissues of these xerophytic plants, they are having the hypodermis and sclerenchyma and conducting tissue, nothing but vascular tissue, are these and are very well developed. Come with another column. See, plant with a special requirement. Up to beginning time, I said about some of the major type of the plants, hydrophytes, water growing plants, mesophytes, generally normal condition, our terrestrial growing plants, xerophytes, very less water available condition plants, available places grown plants, xerophytes. Some of the special plants, here I mentioned two. One is a holophytes, another one is a epiphytes. Halophytes. Halophytes are, halo means saline, phyte means plant, which plants grown in the saline soil, salty places. Okay, such a plants we call as a halophytes. See here, which of the plants are grown in the halophytes, those and all showing the something adaptations. See here I mentioned, which plants are growing in the saline soil. Example, Avicennia. This is the, some I think you didn't heard, these Avicennia. This word you know, mangrove plant. Mangroves. Okay, mangroves plants are which of the plants are grown in the saline places, salt places. Okay, soil if it is having the something salty nature, such a soil onwards these plants can able to adapt to grown in that. So for successful life in that saline conditions, they want to show something adaptations. That morphological adaptations of the halophytes. Morphological adaptations are thin leaves. Leaves are very thin, and then leaf size is very small size, and the leaf is leathery and slime. Why these nature is present exhibited by the leaves? Because of those and all want to prevent the water loss. Those and all want to prevent the water loss. For preventing of the water loss, these halophytes are having the leaves are very small, thin, and then leathery and smiley nature. This is a one of the morphological adaptations of leaf of halophytes. And then come with the next one. It is a very most important characteristic of halophytes. Roots of halophytes are negatively geotropic. What is a negatively geotropic? In 10th standard, Nastic and Nastic movement and Nastic movement we discussed. I mean directional or non-directional movements. Here, some of the plant growth based on the gravitation force, some of the plant parts grown the opposite of gravitation force. For example, roots are grown towards of the gravitation force, stem will be grown apart of gravitation. Halophytic plants roots are come away from the soil, goes opposite of gravitation force. That means aerobial roots. Aerobial roots come out to the atmosphere places. Such a type of roots we call as a pneumatophores. Why these roots are come out from the soil? What is the reason? Here, saline soil does not hold the more oxygen. The soil want to hold the something soil oxygen. If the soil oxygen it is present, that oxygen is useful for root growth, fast growth. But here saline soil not holding the much more oxygen. Lack of oxygen, the root want to oxygen, require oxygen. For absorbing of oxygen wise, that roots come away from the soil to open out the our atmosphere. Such a type of roots, pneumatophores, that based on the functions, roots are playing important role in the respiration. So that's why that pneumatophores also called as a respiratory roots. That you should be remember. Then anatomical adaptations. The anatomical adaptations are shallow root system is there, and lenticels are present, mesenteral anatomical, and salt glands are present. Here very very most important. Basically, if the soil is containing the salt, mean when the soil onwards roots absorbing the water, along with the water some of the minerals also will be enter the plant body. So plant body absorbing or containing the more salt. If more salty, more minerals are present in plant body, means it will be create the side effect to plant. So that's why the excessive salts are removing from the body of from the plant. That's why here salt glands are present. These salt glands function to excessive salts are removed from the body, okay, from the tissues. So remove the salts. These are the anatomical salt glands containing nature, and lenticels are present. That stem containing the stomatas. Stem containing the stomatas, by that one they are can able to respire. They act as a stomatas like. Then shallow root system. These are all anatomical. Up to now what we discussed, halophytes, morphological adaptations, anatomical adaptations. Morphological adaptations are leaf is a small size, and leathery nature slime for regarding for the prevention of the water loss. And then very most important characteristics of these holophytes. Holophytes roots are negatively geotropic. They are come away from the soil and open into the aerobic conditions. Such a roots we call as a pneumatophores. That roots are playing important role in the respiration. So that's why that roots we call as a respiratory roots. And anatomical adaptations, shallow roots, shallow root system, and lenticles on the stem, and then salt glands are present in the body for removing of excessive salt from the plant body. And then one more plant variety, epiphyte. Epi means above. Epi means above. Phyte means plant. Which of the plants grown on the another plant body, that such a type of plants we call as a epiphytes. Here, growing on the other higher plants, a plant growing on the other higher plants. Here examples, wanda and orchids. Wanda and orchids. So, such a epiphytic plants want to survive on the another plant body, it want to show some of the adaptations, morphological adaptation and anatomical adaptations. Morphological adaptations are one is a few leaves. Leaves are very less in number, and that leaves are succulent condition. Then anatomical conditions, adaptations, one is a thick cuticle. They are having the thick cuticle on the leaf body surfaces, and stomatas are sunken stomatas are there. Very very most important character of the epiphytic, maybe there is a question from these type of topic onwards. Velamin tissue present in root. Velamin tissue is nothing but a spongy madri. A spongy like tissue present in the roots. Okay, that roots are hanging on the from that root, I mean from that tree onwards. That roots are absorbing the water from the atmosphere moisture onwards. Because epiphytic plants are grown on the another plant, there is no any soil to take out water from the soil. So the roots want to take the soil in the atmospheric moisture onwards. For absorption wise, roots are containing with a special tissue. That special tissue is a velamin tissue. That velamin tissue useful for absorption of water from the moisture. Moisture will absorb it. Such a nature we can see in the epiphytic adaptations plant. Okay, epiphytic plants. That epiphytic plants are shown the morphological adaptations, anatomical adaptations. Morphological adaptations are few, very less number of leaves, that in succulent condition. And anatomical adaptations, thick cuticle is present and sunken stomatas are present. Especially velamin tissue is present in the root for absorption of water. Here holophytes are having the respiratory roots for respiration wise. Okay, totally in this video we discussed about several plant varieties, that plants are how they are adapted to their climatic conditions, their ecological conditions.